I'm angry that according to a recent Gallup poll, only 45% of Americans would vote for an atheist for president. I'm angry that atheists in the United States are frequently denied custody of their children explicitly because of their atheism. I'm angry on behalf of the atheist blogger in Iran who told me that they have to blog anonymously because if they don't, they'll be executed. I'm angry about preachers who tell women to submit to their husbands because it's the will of God, even when those husbands are beating them within an inch of their lives. I'm angry that people are dying of AIDS in Africa and South America because the Catholic Church convinced them that using condoms makes baby Jesus cry. Yeah. I'm angry that my wife Ingrid and I had to get married 3 times before we finally had a wedding that was legal in our home state. And the Mormon Church spent millions of dollars getting Proposition 8 passed so that no other same-sex couples could get married in California. I'm angry that our marriage is not recognized in 42 states or even by the federal government because religious bigotry controls how laws get made in this country. I'm angry that the current Dalai Lama said that although he supports tolerance for gay people, he sees homosexual sex as wrong, unwholesome, a bad action, and contrary to Buddhist ethics. I'm angry that the belief in karma and reincarnation gets used as a justification for the caste system in India. I'm angry that people who are born into poverty and despair are told that it's their fault, that they did something bad in a past life and they're being punished for it. I'm angry that sick children suffer and die because their parents believe in faith healing. And I'm angry that in 39 states, these parents are protected from prosecution for child neglect. I'm angry that in Islamic theocracies, women who have sex outside marriage, who date outside their religion, who disobey their male relatives, are executed. I'm angry that people in Africa are being terrorized, tortured, and killed over accusations of witchcraft. Okay, witch hunts are happening in Africa now, not in the Middle Ages, not in the 1600s, today. I'm angry that Rick Santorum is a serious candidate for president. His religious beliefs have led him to conclude that states can outlaw birth control, that homosexuality should be illegal, that children are better off with a father in prison than being raised by lesbian parents, and he's not being laughed off the national stage. He's won 10 primaries. I'm angry about lying to the Lord. I'm angry that the Mormon Church advocates a policy of deception, censorship, and outright dishonesty about their religion. I'm angry that Mormons who have told the truth about their church's history have been excommunicated. And I want to ask Mitt Romney, do you believe in lying for the Lord? That when people run for political office, when people run for office in the United States, it's considered invasive and intolerant to ask about their religious beliefs. You know, if somebody's going to be making decisions about science policy, I want to know if they think the Earth was created 6,000 years ago. If somebody's going to be making decisions about foreign policy, I want to know, that the people making decisions about foreign policy, I want to know, do you believe that there has to be violent warfare in Israel to bring about the second coming? And I don't admit the fact that if I ask these questions, I'll be seen as bigoted. I'm angry about what happened to Galileo. I'm still mad. I'm angry that when atheists put up billboards saying simply, you can be good without God, people get outraged at how disrespectful we are. I'm angry that when atheists try to put up a bus sign in Pennsylvania saying simply and entirely the word atheist, the bus company rejected it. I'm angry that we get seen as intolerant and confrontational simply for existing and simply for being open about who we are. I'm angry that I have to know more about their damn religion than they do. I'm angry that in public, taxpayer-paid high schools around the country, atheist students who are trying to organize clubs, something that they are legally allowed to do, are routinely stonewalled by school administrators. I'm angry that in Salt Lake City, Utah, 40% of all homeless teenagers are gay. Most of them kids who have been kicked out by their Mormon families. I'm angry. Okay, angry is not the word. I am enraged at priests who rape children and tell them that it's God's will. I'm angry that the Catholic Church deliberately, repeatedly, for decades, protected these priests. Deliberately kept it a secret. Deliberately placed the church's reputation as a higher priority than children not getting raped. I'm angry about the Holocaust. I'm angry about Israel and Palestine. I'm angry about 9/11. I'm angry about all of it, and I think I'm right to be angry. I think we are all right to be angry. I want to finish up by saying something really important about all of this atheist anger. Most of it is not about how religious believers treat atheists. It's about how believers treat other believers. It's anger on other people's behalf. Atheists aren't angry because we're selfish or bitter or joyless. Atheists are angry because we have compassion. Atheists are angry because we have a sense of justice. Atheists are angry because we see millions of people being terribly harmed by religion, and our hearts go out to them, and we feel motivated to do something about it. Atheists aren't angry because there's something wrong with us. Atheists are angry because there's something right with us.